Okay, hi everybody. I am here today with Rahul Rajshekhar,
yes.
Actor, model, and winner of Mr. India. I'm so flattered and honored that you could be with us today, sir.
This is your fifth take,
you,
right?
Shut up, sir. Anyway, so this is going to be the first of my, hopefully, many interviews with people about the things that they do and hopefully to answer questions that you have asked me. For this one, a friend of mine got in touch and asked about how to get into acting and modeling. And as a male model, he didn't have a lot of resources and I didn't have a lot of answers. So to fill that gap, we have Rahul here. So before we get to the actual questions, I just want to ask, what are you doing now and how you got here? Like, what's your story?
Okay, so right now I'm acting and I'm modeling, and also I do events, which means I train and groom a lot of models across the country. Apart from that, about my acting, I just finished a movie in Malayalam, which was released in the month of Jan 2018, Devanji Mula Grand Prix. I'm still working on another project in Malayalam again. Apart from that, TVCs, shows, events, and that's about it.
So how did you get into modeling and acting?
It's actually quite a strange story, because when I started off as a model, I never wanted to be a model. It was, you know, because of people who pushed me to do it that I got into it. And the biggest reason was I was into fitness. And because I was fit and I got a lot of pictures clicked by some photographers, where I actually went for a photography workshop, and the photographers wanted a male model or a model to stand. They wanted to do some pictures, and I just said, okay, I kept the camera set and I got some pictures clicked. Those pictures were uploaded on Facebook and people started liking, blah, blah, sharing, and that's how I got into modeling.
Nice. So from one side of the camera to the other side.
One side of the camera to the other.
Are you still a photographer?
Well, I do click on and off. Mostly when I travel solo, so I don't,
yeah.
I click animals or probably the nature or something like that. I don't click humans. No, I do click humans, I was just kidding.
Anyway, moving on to the next question. So a lot of guys seem to not know where to start in terms of their own personal grooming. What are some resources or some tips that you have for them?
Okay, so if guys between the age of 18 to 27, if you... above the height of, I think, 5'8", and if you're eligible to be a part of Mr. India pageant, I think you should go for it, because that's a huge platform for all the upcoming aspiring models. They train you, they groom you, the best of the best from the industry, you know, will tell you everything about modeling, acting, and I think that's one of the better platforms. But if you cannot be a part of it, you still can Google a lot about basics, like how to get a portfolio, or how to get your how to walk, how to do a ramp walk. Get few pictures, get few Polaroids, get a basic portfolio. Do not pay anyone, because you know, of late there are a lot of people who scam the aspiring models and they charge them a lot. So I think most of the models who really want to get into this, get a basic portfolio, get an introduction video, get a ramp walk, and start sending it to casting directors all across. And if you want contacts from casting directors, I think the only way to go about it is there are Facebook pages, there are Instagram pages, and also Google. I mean, if you get in touch with me, I can help you out with some. I can even help you out with the portfolio, or I can even help you how to go about it. So you can get in touch with me on Instagram or on my email, and I can help you out. But these are the basics.
I'm going to add his contact information in the description.
Yeah.
So speaking of the portfolio, right, like what are some of the... I've seen some people who've sent me pictures and asked for my opinion, and it's... a lot of like cool angles and things like that, but in my experience it's mostly just the clear cut face and like a clear full
yeah.
length picture that works. So any other tips on what to put together?
So I think more than it's I'm going to put it this way, what to put, no, I'm going to put what not to put.
Okay.
Especially for guys, no sunglasses, no shades, no coolers, nothing. We need to see your eyes. If I'm the client, I need to see your eyes. Don't focus too much on your body. All these guys work out, say, 4 hours a day, they sweat it out. I'm not saying they won't be built, but then the face, the charm is missing. So keep one body shot, maybe or two, and do not try and do something that doesn't suit your face, because off late I've seen everyone with a zero fade and that beard, you know, that sharp beard
yeah.
and that hair,
yeah,
which, you know, whatever.
And then
it doesn't, it doesn't suit them, but then they try to do that because, say, some supermodel is doing it somewhere across the world. So see what suits
yeah.
you the best. Get basic pictures, like get your Polaroids, your face shots, smiling, all angles, your introduction video, which is about 30 seconds. That's your name, your height, your profiles, your age, and probably what languages you could speak. This will help. Apart from that, get some mid shots, your full length shots, so that they know what your frame is. I think that's about it. That's the basic.
Yeah, I think also, I mean, for women also, in addition to that, like Western and Indian for guys
Yeah,
also.
for guys also, you could add in probably you could throw in a suit, you could throw in a casual look, and you could probably do a very, next door kind of a look. So keep about four or five looks in for women, saris, or probably do a sports outfit, or you could do a casual, or it really helps.
Depending on what they're trying to cast you for, they will ask
Yeah,
for
because
specific pictures.
exactly, yeah.
Any tips on how to handle auditions?
Oh yeah, so auditions are gonna. Okay, this is how an audition is gonna be for the ones who have not been to an audition room. The minute you walk in, they're gonna give you a script. Okay, before that, they will see if you fit in or not. So do not get disappointed if you walk into an audition room and they say, "Okay, sorry, you don't fit," even if you have been called, because they might have a 27-year-old who's skinny, who has curly hair, but then you walk in, you're skinny and you like have that fade because that's going on everywhere. Yeah, so you might not fit in. I mean, that's happened to me all the time. That happened to me last month as well. So don't get disappointed. Second thing, go through the script and ask them questions if you have. Third thing, there's going to be a camera. There are going to be 15, 20 people around. So don't get conscious. Just do your bit. And if possible, you could ask for the script the previous day so that you go better prepared.
Yeah, I'll
I
do
do
that.
that. Yeah, even I do that. If they give you the script, well and good. And believe me, they're going to give you just two shots. They're not, because they don't have time, because they're going to audition about, say, 15, no, more than 100 people, I guess. They're going to give you two shots.
You mentioned earlier an introduction video. So what goes into an introduction video?
Okay, the introduction video, you start with your name, your age, your phone number. Some people do not want the phone number, so keep two introduction videos. Wear a black or a white plain t-shirt, your profiles, your height, and also the languages you could speak. Try getting one step closer to the camera if you can. Don't keep it too far. Keep it horizontal always, huh? I think it shouldn't last more than 35 seconds to 40 seconds. That's good.
One thing that I've heard from casting agents is that there's really no point lying about your height or your age in your
You
video. I have had casting agents tell me that I'm one of the first people that they've met who's actually as tall as they claim to be because
Oh,
people just
yeah.
exaggerate their height. And you don't have to because they're casting you for what you actually look like. So might as well just give them your honest truth and get
Absolutely,
the part for
yeah.
that rather than make something up and then go there and then get rejected. So that's one thing I've learned. Has there been anything in the industry that has really surprised you?
So, nothing really surprised me as such. But then, the thing that surprised me the most was the opportunity that each one of us have. Believe me, they still need about, even today at this point, they still need about, say, 1,000 odd models for, say, 5,000 ads, or 5,000 models for 5,000 ads, or whatever it is, or actors. So there's requirement of talent like every single day. So don't ever think, oh, okay, there are already 50 people in that audition, should I go for it? You never know, that casting director might see you today and cast you for another ad. So it's always important for you to meet people also. Just go show your face, just be there.
And there are plenty of opportunities outside of Bombay. Like, this is also one thing that surprised
Yeah,
me.
I'm not, it's not only just Bombay, it's going to be Delhi, it's going to be Bangalore, there's Chennai, there's Kerala. Every city, every state has its own market.
So if you even if you're auditioning here, you may, enter someone in a different region and you might get those parts as well. So
Absolutely.
that's
Like, I do a lot of ads for Chennai, I do a lot of ads in Kerala, being in Bangalore because I fly out and do some ads. You never know, you could get booked internationally as well.
I've heard from friends that they've gone to like Japan
Oh,
to shoot
yeah.
videos. Like the video ends up being like 10 seconds long, but they got flown out to
Absolutely.
Japan
Yeah,
for it.
exactly.
I think the most important thing though is that I've had a lot of conversations with people about how they want to start and how they want to do something, and then it just ends at the conversation. So I think the most important thing is to actually just start doing it.
Yeah, you're never ready. The thing about getting a portfolio, going for an audition, or meeting someone is you're never ready because you'll be like, okay, I'm going to be better in the next 2 months. But then I'm not saying you won't get better, but once you're better, you obviously have a different goal. You want to aim for something higher. A start is the most important thing. And once you get your first portfolio or your first, once you go for your first audition, I think everything is going to be easy.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah.
And one day you can be a real life movie star like
Nah.
this dude. I'm so grateful you're here, dude. Thanks.
Oh.
I have a thank you gift for you.
You do? Okay. Ah, okay. Yeah,
Thank
I know.
you.
I know. Thank you,
That's
gift.
it. That's it. Just
That's
kidding, I
it.
gave him chocolate yesterday to bribe him to come here.
Absolutely.
So yeah, this is how business deals get done. Don't wait for anyone.
Don't wait for anyone. If you No, learn from that. If you want something, find a way to get it done.
Yeah, I just
She
asked.
Wanted me to come here, she bribed me with a chocolate.
Done.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyway, thank you all. Hopefully this helped answer some questions. His contact information and mine will be in the description if you have any specific questions. Okay, thanks. Okay, bye.
Have you done?
I'm still making you wait for some more time.
Oh, really?